Good morning, students of class 4. Students, I'm sure all of you are happy and healthy. Students, please take out your English grammar book and turn to page number 75 as I'll be starting with unit 90, articles. Students, please take out your English grammar book. Turn the page to page number 75 as I'll be starting with unit 19, articles. Students, in my last video, I had explained and completed exercise 4 and 5 of unit 18, simple past tense. And I'm sure all of you must have completed all the exercises of unit 18 in your English grammar book. And children, today I'm going to start with unit 19, articles. Now, students, all of you know that a, an, the, these three are articles, है ना? ये हमने junior classes में भी पढ़ा है. Now we'll revise a little bit कि where do we use am and when do we use the. Fine. And in this article we also use learn the use where articles are required and not required both. Fine. Now, you all know that a, an, the, these three are articles, है ना? बेटा, a, an, the, these three are articles. Whereas, a and an, they do not refer to a particular, they do not refer to a particular person, place, animal, or thing. You need to keep in mind that a and an, they do not refer to a particular person, place, animal or thing. So that is the reason they are known as indefinite article. That's the reason they are known as indefinite articles, because ye kisi definite person, place, animal ko refer nahi karte hain. Hum inko kab use karte hain? When we speak in general about one, है ना? A and N symbolizes one. किसी भी singular person, place, animal or thing in general के लिए हम use करते हैं, but you should keep in mind कि ये हम किसी एक चीज के लिए use करते हैं. And ये किसी definite के लिए नहीं हम use करते हैं. So that's the reason they are known as indefinite article. Whereas the points out some particular person, place, animal, or thing. The points out to some particular person, place, animal or thing, and that's the reason they are, the is known as definite article. Kyunki ye kisi definite person, place, animal or thing ko point out karte hain, and that's the reason the is known as definite article. Now, you need to keep in mind कि A और N हम किसी बेटा singular countable nouns के साथ ही use करते हैं. They are used only with singular countable nouns. You need to keep in mind कि A और N हम singular countable noun के साथ ही use करते हैं. Whereas the is used with both singular and plural, singular and plural, countable and uncountable nouns. हम सिंगुलर प्लूरल दोनों के साथ यूज करते हैं काउंटेबल एंड अनकाउंटेबल नाउंस. दिस यू नीड टू कीप इन माइंड. वेयर इज ए और एन हम किसी पर्टिकुलर पर्सन प्लेस एनिमल थिंग के लिए नहीं यूज करते. इन जनरल वी यूज बट इट इज ओनली यूज विद सिंगुलर काउंटेबल नाउन. एंड ए एंड एन रिफर्स टू ओनली वन थिंग. किसी भी एक चीज के लिए हम ए और एन यूज करते हैं. वेयर इज द इज यूज्ड विद बोथ सिंगुलर एंड प्लूरल काउंटेबल एंड अनकाउंटेबल नाउंस. थिंग्स दैट कैन बी काउंटेड, थिंग्स विच कैन नॉट बी काउंटेड, है ना. तो ये आपको बेटा दिमाग में रखना है कि जो द डेफिनेट आर्टिकल द है ये सिंगुलर प्लूरल बोथ काउंटेबल एंड अनकाउंटेबल नाउंस के साथ यूज किया जाता है. द इज नोन एज डेफिनेट आर्टिकल. वेयर इज ए एंड एन आर नोन एज indefinite articles. Fine, the definite article है, ये दो है, इसलिए indefinite article. Clear? Now, अभी तक हमने बेटा पढ़ा था कि हम a और n कहाँ use करते हैं, ना? A हम we use it before all the words, है ना? जो consonant जिनमें जो consonant से start होते हैं, जिनमें consonant का sound होता है, उनके आगे हम क्या use करते हैं a. Whereas, जिन words vowel से start करते हैं और जिनमें vowel का sound होता है उनके लिए हम कौन सा बेटा indefinite article use करते हैं, n, है ना. n is used, now n is used, you need to keep this in mind, before words that begin with vowels. Or vowels, I hope all of you know, A, E, I, O and U. ये हमारे vowels हैं. और हम N उन सारे words जिन जो भी जिनमें भी जो बिगिन विथ अ वावल साउंड, ये आपको ध्यान रखना है कि वावल से तो है बट उनमें वावल का साउंड भी आना चाहिए. दैट इज इम्पोर्टेंट, है ना. कि कोई भी वर्ड इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी कि हो सकता है वो कॉन्सनेंट से स्टार्ट होता है. जैसे आर, एच ओ यू आर आर, वो स्टार्ट विथ अ कॉन्सनेंट बट इट इज गॉट अ वावल साउंड. सो नाउ यू नीड टू कीप इन माइंड दैट दे मस्ट हैव अ वावल साउंड. They must have a vowel sound. For example, R. R begins with a consonant, but then this particular word has got vowel sound, है ना? R, है ना? बेटा, इसके लिए सबसे आसान तरीका है जो हमारी हिंदी की मात्राएं हैं, स्वर है, अ, आ, ई, ई, ए, आई, ओ, औ, है ना? ये सब वावल साउंड्स हैं. और कोई भी वर्ड जिसमें इनका साउंड आ रहा है, स्वर का साउंड आ रहा है, उसमें आप एन ही यूज करोगे. इसको आप ऐसे दिमाग पे बैठा के रखो. और कोई अगर वर्ड मे बी स्टार्टिंग विथ अ वावल बट उसमें कॉन्सनेंट का साउंड आ रहा है तो उनके आगे आपको ए लगाना है. तो आप स्वर और व्यंजन को दिमाग में बैठा के रखो. आई होप सब बच्चों को स्वर और व्यंजन पता है, है ना. तो जितनों वर्ड्स में भी आपको वावल साउंड आता है, दो दे में भी स्टार्टिंग विद अ कॉन्सनेंट, उनके आगे हमेशा क्या यूज करेंगे, एन, है ना. दे मस्ट हैव अ वावल साउंड. दिस यू नीड टू कीप इन माइंड, है ना. नाउ इफ यू सी ऑन पेज नंबर 75, यू कैन सी द एग्जांपल्स. एन एलिगेटर, an ox, an eagle, an igloo, an umbrella, an S, है ना. ये सारे वर्ड्स हैं बेटा, इनके आगे क्या लगा है, एन. because they all have got vowel sound. Fine. And ox, you can see the examples. And eagle, they are starting also with a vowel and they have vowel sound also. So these are some examples which you need to keep in mind ki koi bhi word ho, hai na, though it may start with a consonant but they should have a vowel sound. That is important. Clear? So I hope now the use of N is clear to you. Now let's see the use of A. Fine. A is used with words that begin with consonants. Anna? Total, there are 26 alphabets, out of which 5 are vowels and the remaining are consonants. So all the words that begin with a consonant and they must have a consonant sound. The most important thing to be noticed is they must have a consonant sound. This you need to keep in mind ki koi bhi letter hai na unme consonant sound hona jaruri hai, hai na? Let's take the example. Okay, a medal, hai na? Look at the example. Medal, it is starting with consonant. M is a consonant and has got a consonant sound also. A flower, starting with the consonant, having a consonant sound also. A dictionary, hai na? So consonants start ho rahe hain aur consonant sound bhi hai. A zebra, a parrot. So these are the words which begin with a consonant and are having consonant sounds also. But now the thing to be noticed is that let's take the word unicorn. Now look at this word unicorn. The word unicorn starts with U. And what is U? U is a vowel. U to vowel hai, hai na? Now you can see unicorn, hai na? हम इसको बोल रहे हैं यूनिकॉर्न. तो कहीं इसमें वावल का साउंड आ रहा है? नहीं. इसमें किसका साउंड आ रहा है? य का, वाई का, है ना? हिंदी में अगर हम देखें तो व्यंजन य का साउंड आ रहा है और अगर अल्फाबेट्स पकड़े तो वाई का. व्हाट इज वाई? वाई इज अ कॉन्सोनेंट. सो इसीलिए इसके आगे वी विल यूज अ यूनिकॉर्न. एम आई क्लियर? सो द वर्ड्स though they may start with the vowel but if they have a consonant sound you will use the indefinite article A before it. Now let's look at another example. Useful thing, hai na? Useful thing. So what? Useful thing. Again that Y sound is coming, hai na? कहीं भी इसमें वावल का साउंड नहीं आ रहा है, य वाई वाला साउंड आ रहा है. यूजफुल थिंग. सो अ यूजफुल थिंग. देन लेट्स टेक अनदर एग्जांपल. 1 रुपी कॉइन. अब वन में है ना, अगर इसको मैं हिंदी में लिखूं वन तो ये क्या होगा? व. डब्ल्यू का साउंड आ रहा है, डब्ल्यू का साउंड आ रहा है ना? V का sound, VW sound is coming. So V and W both are what? They are consonant. So हम हमेशा जो वर्ड्स जिनमें कॉन्सोनेंट का साउंड आएगा उनके आगे हम क्या यूज करेंगे बेटा, अ, है ना। सो यू नीड टू रिमेम्बर कि दो दी वर्ड में बी स्टार्टिंग विथ अ वावल, बट इफ दे हैव अ कॉन्सोनेंट साउंड वी विल यूज द इनडेफिनेट आर्टिकल ए बिफोर देन। फाइन, नाउ आई होप the use of a and n is clear to you. Now let's start with exercise 1, and after this exercise 1 I will explain the use of definite article the. Clear? So aapko bas itna bhi beta dimag mein rakhna hai ki jin bhi words mein consonant ka sound aayega, dode mein bhi starting with a vowel we will use a before then, and jin bhi वर्ड्स में वावल का साउंड आएगा दो दे में भी स्टार्टिंग विद अ कंसोनेंट उनके आगे हम क्या यूज करेंगे बेटा, एन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद एक्सरसाइज 1, एंड दैट इज पुट ए और एन बिफोर दीज words. Now, all of you, I hope all of you have turned to page number 76. We are doing exercise 1. Fine? Now, the first one. Dash ring. R-I-N-G ring. It starts with R, that's a consonant, and it is got a consonant sound also, so we will write a ring. Then the second one, dash, expensive ring. Now, expensive, the word starts with E, with a vowel, and has got a vowel sound also, so we will use N. N, expensive ring. Then the third word is dash egg. The word egg starts with E, and E is a vowel, and egg has got the vowel sound. So we will use N, egg. Then the fourth one, dash golden egg. Now the word golden, it starts with a consonant and has got a consonant sound. So we will write a golden egg. Then, fifth one, dash easy question. Now, the word easy starts with E and has got a vowel sound, so we will be writing an before it, an easy question. Then the sixth one, dash tough question. Now the word tough starts with T and has got a consonant sound, and starting also with consonant, so we will use a tough question. Then the seventh word is dash hammer. Now the word hammer starts with H, which is a consonant, and it has got a consonant sound also, so we will write a hammer. Then the next one, dash blazer. Now the word blazer starts with B, which is a consonant, and has got a consonant sound, so we will write a blazer. So let's revise these. The first one, a ring. Second, an expensive ring. Third, an egg. Fourth, a golden egg. Fifth, an easy question. Sixth, a tough question. Seventh, a hammer. Eighth, a blazer. Fine? Now, the ninth one. Dash friend. Now, the word friend starts with F, and it has got a consonant sound. F is a consonant sound, consonant, and the word friend has got a consonant sound. So, we will write A, a fret. Then the 10th one, dash, bucket. Now the word bucket starts with a consonant B and has got a consonant sound. So we will use a bucket. Then the 11th one, dash, empty, bucket. Now, the word empty starts with E, which is a vowel, and it has got a vowel sound, so we will use N in the 11th line. So it will be an empty bucket. Then the 12th one, dash, vulture. Now, the word vulture starts with V. V is a consonant and it has got a consonant sound, so we will be writing a vulture. Then the 13th one, a dash, rose, flower. The word rose starts with R, which is a consonant, and it has got a consonant sound, so we will be using the indefinite article A, a rose flower. Then the 14th one, dash, orchid, stick. Orchid is a kind of flower, children, and the word starts with O, which is a vowel and has got a vowel sound, orchid. So we will be using the indefinite article N in the 14th line. So it will be an orchid flower, an orchid stick. Then the 15th one, dash, one rupee coin. Now you need to look at this word carefully. The word one starts with O, which is a vowel, fine? But when you speak aloud, the sound comes of a consonant. One, hai na? V ka sound aa raha hai. Kahi bhi A, R, E, E, A, I, O, A ka sound nahi aa raha hai. V ka sound aa raha hai, V vyanjan hai, hai na? Aur jisme bhi vyanjan ka sound aa hai. So you need to keep in mind ki vyanjan matlab consonant. So we need to write A before it. Kabhi bhi aap N nahi use karoge, क्योंकि इसमें वावल का साउंड तो है ही नहीं, कॉन्सनेंट का साउंड है. सो वी विल बी यूजिंग अ वन रुपी कॉइन. देन द लास्ट वन, 16th वन, डैश, आर्म चेयर. नाउ द वर्ड आर्म स्टार्ट्स विद ए व्हिच इज अ वावल एंड इट हैज गॉट अ वावल साउंड, सो वी विल बी यूजिंग आर्म, आर्म चेयर. Fine. So let's revise, children. The 9th one is a friend. 10, a bucket. 11, an empty bucket. 12, a vulture. 13, a rose flower. 14, an orchid stick. 15, a 1 rupee coin. And 16, an armchair. So now I'm going to revise all these 16 and then I'm going to start with exercise 2. Let's revise so that I can erase. First one, a ring. Second, an expensive ring. Third, an egg. Fourth, a golden egg. Fifth, an easy question. Sixth, a tough question. Seventh, a hammer. Eighth, a blazer. Ninth, a friend. Tenth, a bucket. 11th, an empty bucket. 12th, a vulture. 13th, a rose flower. 14th, an orchid stick. 15th, a 1 rupee coin. 16th, an armchair. Fine. So you need to keep in mind that A and N are known as indefinite articles, and we need to keep in mind that we'll use A before the words which start with a consonant and they must have a consonant sound too. Whereas we use N with all, before all the words which begin with the vowel and have got A, they must have a vowel sound too. And A and N are used with singular countable nouns. Fine. So now I'm going to erase exercise 1 and start with exercise 2. Now, exercise 2 is fill in the blanks with A or N. Fine. Now the first one, dash parasol is quite like dash umbrella. Now Julie, look at the words after the blank. Dash parasol. Hana? Parasol starts with P, which is a consonant. It has got a consonant sound. So before parasol, we'll be using the indefinite article A, and we'll be writing capital A because we are starting the sentence with it. So a parasol is quite like dash umbrella. The word umbrella starts with U and it has got a vowel sound too. Starts with U, which is a vowel, and has got a vowel sound. So we will be using the indefinite article N in it. Fine. So our sentence will be, a parasol is quite like an umbrella. Then the second one. Muskan has dash pet dog Google. She bought dash egg and made dash omelette for the dog. Now, Muskan has dash pet dog. अब हमें जो आर्टिकल यूज करना है किसके लिए यूज करना है, पेट डॉग के लिए. सो द वर्ड पेट स्टार्ट्स विद पी व्हिच इज अ कंसोनेंट, इट हैज गॉट अ कंसोनेंट साउंड आल्सो. सो वी विल बी राइटिंग अ. सो इन द फर्स्ट ब्लैंक राइट अ. मुस्कान हैज अ पेट डॉग गूगल. शी बॉट डैश एग. नाउ आफ्टर द ब्लैंक व्हिच वर्ड इज देयर, एग. द वर्ड एग स्टार्ट्स विद अ vowel E and it has got a vowel sound also, so we'll be using N in the second blank. We'll be writing N in the second blank. Vowel sound here and starts with the vowel, so we'll be writing N in the second blank. She bought an egg and made dash omelette for the dog. The word omelette starts with O, which is a vowel. It has got a vowel sound also, so we'll be writing N in the third blank. So our sentence is, Muskan has a pet dog. Right, A in the first blank of the second one. Google. She bought an egg. Right, N in the second blank. And made dash omelette. Right, N in the third blank. Omelette for the dog. So Muskan has a pet dog, Google. She bought an egg and made an omelette for the dog. Now the third one, I brought dash pair of socks and dash black coat. Now I bought, now the word pair of socks, the word P is a consonant. Pair starts with the word P, which is a consonant. It has got a consonant sound. So we will write a pair of socks. I bought a pair of socks and dash black coat. The word black starts with a consonant B and has got a consonant sound. So we write a. So our sentence will be, I brought a pair of socks and a black coat. Fine? Write fast, children. So, children, I hope you all now have understood the use of the indefinite article A and N. Well, that's all for today. I'll be continuing the rest of this exercise in my next video. Please do revise all the taught exercise. That's all for today. Thank you, students. Have a good day ahead.